My family will tell you my number one thing in being in sales that's really important is the answer is no unless you ask the question. So you have to ask the question, otherwise it's no.
Insightful conversations with the people shaping the title and escrow industry. Hosted by CloseSimple co-founder Bill Svoboda and brought to you by CloseSimple, the trusted name in closing communication, helping title and escrow companies communicate during the closing with automated text messages, custom branded email, and the pizza tracker for title timeline. And now, closing talks.
Hey, Linda, thank you for hopping on with me today. How are you doing over there? Where are you today?
Oh, it's good to see you, Bill. I miss seeing your face. I am actually on Block Island, Rhode Island. So I've spent a lot of time out here since I'm not traveling. And it's a little island off the coast of Rhode Island.
It looks amazing. It looks like home right there. I have to visit Rhode Island someday.
Come on down.
Well, I'm excited to chat with you here today. It's been a few months since I've seen you. And the reason why I wanted to bring you on today to talk to me is because out of all the people I've met in the title industry, there are a few people that stick out to me as somebody I would say feels like family. Somebody that no matter what conference I go to, now you're a vendor as well as I'm a vendor. We're both, you know, we're not title agents. But you have this unique ability, I would say, to cross the line from being a vendor speaking to title agents to being family, no matter who you're talking to. You take it from a transaction to family. And what I really kind of just wanted to get out of our time together today was, how do you do that? What does it look like to go from a relationship at a conference to feeling like family, and maybe taking away one or two things that anybody watching this, title agents, owners, managers, salespeople, processors, what can they do to take it from a relationship with a realtor or mortgage professional to feeling more like family? Does that sound good?
Just, you have to be real. You have to be yourself. I love people and I love learning about people. It's taking the time to actually listen and care and understand that people are going through, difficulties or successes, and rejoicing with them or sitting there and holding their hand while they're, you know, discussing some difficulty that they're going through. So even though I'm a vendor, like I have always said, my trade shows, when I go out on the road, it's seeing my family. And that's what I've missed the most during COVID is my family, my title industry family. And you don't have to be a customer of mine. I just want to know who you are. And as long as you're real and we get along and you're funny, being funny is really huge for me.
One thing I've gotten from you over the years, and maybe this is a first takeaway for any title agent in, I don't know, even an escrow officer, sales manager, owner, is you bridge that gap. You pull people into your family because you talk about your family too.
Right.
Like you connect on what matters most to the person that you're talking to. You do that with me so well. I feel like every time I meet you, you know, you actually ask, how are things going on a personal
Absolutely.
Level? You go from business. So what does that look like for you? How are you so comfortable in that? Because I don't think a lot of people are.
Well, I have the number one priority in my life is my family. And so I think that just shines through. I love people and they become a part of me. I want to learn more about them. Whenever I see you, I'm interested in what's going on in your life because I care about you. And I think if you're genuine and you meet people and you're connecting with them, it's important, again, to be real and, you know, be caring to them and understanding anything that they're going through. It's being a friend. And once we connect and spend time together, as you know, when I see you at NS3, when we go, I'm jumping into your arms and getting a big hug because I miss it.
I remember the first time we met, it was actually in Duluth, Minnesota. It was one of my first title conferences ever. I'm a Minnesota guy. You can hear the accent on me. I had no idea that you weren't from Minnesota because you fit right into that. And I thought, this woman knows everybody here and people love talking to you. We hopped on a boat that night for like the boat cruise dinner. And instantly I go, you have to meet this person though too. Like, and it felt natural. Yeah. Talk to me about this. You're right now, your role at Require, you're director of national sales, right? Is that the official title?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. From your unique vantage point over this past year, as you look at title agents across the country, is there maybe one or two things that you've seen title companies really encounter through COVID that have created opportunities for them to go to the next level?
Yeah. So one of the big opportunities is because the real estate market has been so crazy, people have been stuck on title issues because of unreleased liens. So there, we've seen a huge influx in our title curative department. But what really sticks out to me personally is that I haven't been able to travel. I haven't been able to go out there and connect with people, but I have made so many relationships in the industry. I've been in the industry since I was 18 years old. So you don't even want to know how long I've been in the industry for. But I've made so many relationships in the industry that I've become a resource to people and not necessarily my clients, but anybody in the industry to go to for who can I get to start doing our searches? Who can I talk to about an integration? Who can I talk to about new banking? So all of the people in my network and my family in the title insurance industry, I love referring them business. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be release tracking, any type of business to help them out. Because I think if you have a large network and you've been in the industry this long, it's really important to share that knowledge with other people to make the whole community successful. Not only the vendors getting the business, but assisting the title agents in getting those closings done, because we know it's been a crazy year with closings.
You know, Tom Ferry, one of the biggest real estate coaches for a lot of real estate agents and brokers and even mortgage, I don't think title looks at him as much, but Tom Ferry has been saying that right now it's all about being a knowledge broker. It's all about knowledge.
Right.
What do you know? Because people can go online, type in what is the best. And people always say best fill in the blank. And I think you hit it on the head. It's now people are coming, they're open to what should I be doing now? And you position yourself there really as that knowledge broker.
Yeah. And I've had such a long history in the title industry that I can read title. I was a closer. I sold title insurance. So I know about title insurance policies. I know about claims. I know about recordings. So I've become a useful tool, not only to my strategic alliances, but also to, you know, consumers will find my name on the internet. And of course, you find my name, you find my cell phone number. And I'm the girl that always picks up, even if it's 10 o'clock at night. And I've been able to help even the consumers or real estate agents that just have questions because I take the time to talk to them. I don't necessarily have to get business out of them. I just have a passion about the title industry. It's been my life and I want to share my knowledge. You know, I don't want to, there's no sense in keeping the knowledge to yourself. You might as well share it with people and assist them to make their experience better in our industry. Cause you know, we need a good reputation in this industry because we're very important to the whole real estate process.
So speaking of industry and family and knowledge base there, your daughter is actually in the title industry also, but she doesn't work for your company. She actually works for a title agent, right? How did that happen? Talk to me about that.
You know, it's a great story actually, Bill. So I was at a conference in New Orleans and she went to the College of Charleston and they evacuated Charleston because there was a hurricane coming. And she was, I think, a senior at the College of Charleston. And she calls me up and she says, Mom, I have to come home. They're evacuating Charleston. And I said to her, honey, I'm not home. I'm in New Orleans at a conference. And she said, I like New Orleans. So we flew her to New Orleans and I said to her, well, you have to work. You know, you're going to be here as a guest. I talked to the head of the conference to make sure she could come in. And I put her on the table. Put her right on the vendor floor because I know she's got a great personality. And you know, Bill, when she graduated from high school, she said to me, "Mom, I know this is crazy, but I would really be interested in working in your industry." And NS3 was happening in June, and she had just graduated. And I'm sure I talked to you. I was out there on the floor saying, "Who wants, you know, to employ my daughter?" And do you know she got about 5 interviews from my connections out of NS3? All of those turned into offers, and she's been working for this title agent out of Manhattan for the last 4 years. So she's really become successful, and we need new blood in this industry because we're all aging out of it.
So let me ask you this. Your daughter is in the industry. What were the 1 or 2 big pointers that you gave her as she was starting? Like what was the lesson that you could say from your years of experience? Did you have 1 or 2 big things?
Oh, absolutely. I'm her mama. I have a lot of things to say. My family will tell you my number one thing, and being in sales, it's really important, is the answer is no, unless you ask the question. So you have to ask the question. Otherwise it's no, you can't move forward on it. And the second thing is you have to be true to who you are. Never lie to a customer. Never make up an excuse or a lie to them, because your reputation is all you have in any type of sales. And always respond. Even if it's a tough decision or you have to have a tough conversation with someone because perhaps you failed on your part or something's wrong, you know, the title is so bad that they're going to have a quiet title action. You have to be honest with them and have that discussion with them. So honesty, integrity, and always ask the question. Communication is key. Key.
That's great. And coming from you, she knows how many years of experience you've had. She has to take that advice and run with it. And again, knowledge broker. Knowledge is the new currency. And that's exactly, I think, you know, going back to why I wanted to talk to you, because relationships, you bring people into a real relationship. It feels like family because you want to see your family win. You don't just want to get the deal out of them. Let me ask you this here. Last question. What's keeping you up at night right now in the industry? If you think about it, what's the biggest thing that keeps running through your mind?
The title insurance and how important title insurance is to the industry. There's a lot of advocates that think that the insurance is unnecessary. But when you look at title insurance, it's the least expensive insurance you're going to pay for anything because it's not a yearly premium. It protects the number one investment that you ever make. And I wrote an ebook called The Life of the Mortgage Loan with a friend in the mortgage industry for me. And it talks about the value that the title insurance agent brings to the whole lending process. And we really can't have, we can't do without each other. We have to work together, but I think it's the fear that people don't truly see the value of title insurance, especially an owner's policy. And it's really important for the consumers, along with the lobbyists and people down in DC and Alta does a great job in championing the title industry, to know how important that title insurance is. So we know it every single day. We do thousands. Some people do thousands a week. But the average consumer, we have to take them each individually, not as a whole. So you have to have patience every single time you touch a consumer, because they've perhaps never done this before, or they did it 10 years ago and so much has changed in the industry that they don't understand it anymore. So having patience with them and understanding that this is their very first time and explaining why title insurance is so valuable. So this product never goes away.
So what I'm hearing again is that knowledge broker thing. It's really just that teaching, pulling them closer to the answer that they want, that they need. And that's what Require really helps with. It helps get that closing done right. And it adds value.
Yeah. It also keeps me up at night wondering how I could tell the world what we do, because I find new people all the time saying, "I didn't know you did that." So, you know, I want to take out billboards and say, "We clear title. We make it successful for you to close on that loan."
I would love to see the day though, like, you know, like you said, a Require billboard, like Require. What was the tagline under it? What would you say?
Clear title, clear mind.
Clear title, clear, you know, whatever you want to say for require, I'd love to go down the highway someday instead of seeing the realtors, you know, with their arms wide or, you know, the big brokers. I'd love to see like title companies on, you know, like, gosh, there's a lot. Like I'd love to think that we could make title attractive. You know, title could be something. Like I'm waiting for the day
that you do that all on your own. I mean, you just do that all on your own.
I'm waiting for the day though. I'm driving down the street that I see a title company on the billboard. You know, like I'm waiting for the day that the shift happens to where title becomes something that people go, yes, I want to close with that company, Mr. or Mrs. Realtor. I want to go there because I think there's a huge opportunity.
Well,
there.
There's your takeaway. So, I mean, the takeaway from this is all your title agents out there need to go and put up billboards.
Nah, who knows? Who knows? Right. You know, I'm just saying, I want to see that day come. I think that's going to be awesome when this industry gets the credit for all the hard work that they do.
It's a lot of work. It's a lot of work and a lot of knowledge that you have to have in order to be a successful title agent. So, you know, it's people don't understand how much work goes into doing what we do.
Yeah. Well, Linda, thank you so much for hopping on with me here today. It's been an absolute pleasure catching up and looking forward to seeing you at the next conference.
Absolutely, Bill. And everybody out there, don't be afraid to come up and chat with me. I'd love to meet new people and bring you into my family.
There we go. Well, you have a great day. Thanks.
You too. Thanks, Bill.